Finally, tonight, a musical collaboration with a most unlikely duo. One, a living legend known for his voice and smooth style. The other, one of the biggest pop stars on the planet. Jeffrey Brown has the story.
I won't dance. Why should I?
A classic from the 1930s, popularized by Fred Astaire and Ginger Rogers, the kind of song you might still expect from one of the greatest ever crooners of American standards, Tony Bennett.
So if I hold you in my arms, I will dance.
But not so much from his duet partner, Lady Gaga, one of today's mega pop stars. She's known for her shape-shifting persona and over-the-top performances, where millions of devout followers call themselves little monsters, and for hits like Bad Romance. But there they are together, dancing cheek-to-cheek on a new album that hit number one on the charts, as well as a PBS Great Performances special debuting tonight. The 88-year-old Bennett is one of the last of a bygone era that included Frank Sinatra, Sammy Davis Jr., and Dean Martin.
I left my
heart. Oh, yeah.
In San Francisco.
Later in life, he's been reaching out to collaborate with artists often well outside his generation or genre or both.
How do you lose yourself to someone?
In 2011, for example, he celebrated his 85th birthday by recording with the likes of Aretha Franklin, Willie Nelson, the late Amy Winehouse, and other stars, including Lady Gaga.
That's why this chick is a tram.
That experience, he told me yesterday in New York, made him want to work with Lady Gaga again.
I love performing with her. She loves performing with me. And she happens to be a wonderful jazz singer. She improvises beautifully. Funny enough, she started out as a jazz singer and was kind of turned down. The promoters said, you know, do something more contemporary and what the young people like and all that. And she regretted it. When I listened to her, I said, by the way, you sing so spontaneously and beautiful. Let's do a jazz album together. She said, I'd love it. And so I put together a tremendous swinging big band with the best jazz artists around.
The greatest thing you will ever learn.
You, 88?
88, right.
Why are you still doing this?
I love it.
Yeah?
I was blessed with a wonderful Italian-American family. My father died when I was 10 years old. And all my relatives, aunts, uncles, nieces, nephews, they would come over every Sunday. And my brother, my sister, and myself would entertain them. They'd make a circle around us.
Mm-hmm.
And it was just at a time, being 10 years old, I'm saying, what am I going to do in life? I mean, is anybody ever going to know me or anything like that? And my family would say, we like the way you sing, and we like the way you paint those flowers.
Mm-hmm.
So they created a passion in me of always trying to improve. And here I am, 88, and I'm still working at trying to get better and better at what I'm doing.
You still feel that, right?
Oh, absolutely.
I mean, you remember that young guy first starting to sing,
mm-hmm.
and then here you are still singing?
Well, I was blessed under the GI Bill of Rights when I came out of the service in the war. I joined the American Theater Wing. And it was a great choice that they allowed us to continue school that we missed during the war. The main thing that I learned from them was to always stay with quality, never compromise. You know, don't just try and get a hit record. Let's do something that's going to last
mm-hmm.
and that's intelligent.
Mm-hmm.
So I treat the audience that way.
What about treating yourself and you're taking care of yourself, taking care of your voice to keep going?
Right. I had good training with good teachers that taught me how to sing properly. And three times a week I exercise and I stay in shape and have a wonderful wife that treats me wonderful. And so I feel very good about life, and I will never retire.
You'll never retire?
No.
Why do you say that? You're clear about that.
I'm just starting to learn now.
Bennett also still works hard to make sure that young people learn about the arts. The foundation that he and his wife set up, Exploring the Arts, works in public schools in lower-income areas of New York, including in neighborhoods where he himself grew up, that otherwise have little access to the arts. He told me he's especially eager to help keep the jazz music he loves alive, and that, too, ties into the new work with Lady Gaga.
Unfortunately, the record companies think in a contemporary way, and they don't realize how powerful jazz is. It's the only great art form that's ever been created in the United States by African Americans in New Orleans. They invented it to improvise, elongated improvisation. And it's a wonderful art. And for whatever reason, they don't promote it enough. So that's the reason I did the album with Lady Gaga, to reach that young audience that she has. And for the first time in their life, they hear wonderful songs that swing and last forever. They're great American songs that were done in the 20s and 30s.
And you're hoping once young people hear these songs, they'll want to hear more?
It's the first time they've ever heard it.
Through you and Lady Gaga, huh?
Right. Exactly.
All right, Tony Bennett, thanks so much for talking to us.
Well, thank you very much. Thank you.